Unbridled academic freedom.
After Dr. Caroline Crocker simply mentioned intelligent design in her cell biology class at George Mason University, her promising academic career came to an abrupt end.
My supervisor invited me into his office. He said, "I'm going to have to discipline you for teaching creationism." And I said, "I mentioned intelligent design on a couple of slides, but I did not teach creationism." He said, "Nonetheless, you have to be disciplined." At the end of the semester, I lost my job.
Not only did this well-loved professor lose her job at George Mason, she suddenly found herself blacklisted, unable to find a job anywhere.
So whenever I interviewed for a job, I would be offered it, usually on the spot. Since this has happened, and since people can Google my name, I'm finding that when I send my credentials, I do get interviews, I get many interviews, but I never get offered a job. I don't tell them about my science sin. I was only trying to teach what the university stands for, which is academic freedom.
There's nothing to be learned in neurosurgery by assuming an accidental origin for the parts of the brain that we work on.
It wasn't just biologists who were feeling the Darwinist wrath. When neurosurgeon Michael Egnor wrote an essay to high school students saying doctors didn't need to study evolution in order to practice medicine, the Darwinists were quick to try and exterminate this new threat.
A lot of people on a lot of blogs called me unprintable names that were printed. There are a lot of very, very nasty comments. Other people suggested that people call the university I work at and suggested perhaps it's time for me to retire. I realized when I kind of went public with my doubts about the adequacy of Darwin's theory that I would encounter criticism. What has amazed me is the viciousness and the sort of baseness of it.
I'm an old guy, I have tenure, I'm academically safe, but the young people and what is happening to them in America right now because of this scientism gulag is really terrible.
Apparently, Professor Marks was not as safe as he thought. A few months after this interview, Baylor University shut down his research website and forced him to return grant money once they discovered a link between his work and intelligent design.
In order to attract grants, you have to market yourself. So you put up sites and call yourself labs and groups and things like that in order to get visibility. And in my entire experience in academia, I never went to any superior and asked them any permission to put up any of these labs. So the fact that this was singled out, let alone shut down, is jaw-dropping. It's astonishing. I have never been treated like this in my about 30 years in academia.
Shut up, you freak! I say shut up! It's a man!
If you peel back the onion, I think that there is no doubt that the center of this is my work in what some would call intelligent design.
People really get emotional about this. Whenever you say intelligent design in a room of academics, them's fighting words.
Creationists.
Astronomer Guillermo Gonzalez found himself in a fierce shootout with Iowa State University following the publication of his book, arguing that the universe is intelligently designed. Despite a stellar research record that has led to the discovery of several planets, his application for tenure was denied, putting his career in jeopardy.
I worried about my tenure a little bit in 2005 when the petition was being circulated because I viewed that as a strategy of Hector Avalos and his associates to try to poison the atmosphere on campus against me because he knew I wasn't tenured yet and I was very vulnerable. I have little doubt that I would have tenure now if I hadn't done any professional work on intelligent design.
Dr. Gonzalez had this advice for scientists who might be thinking about following his example.
If they value their careers, they should keep quiet about their intelligent design views.
We know there are times and places to be quiet, and other times and places when we can make noise if we want to.
Will you show us?
Of course. Boys and girls, how would you like to show some of the ways we know of being quiet?
It's the kind of thing where you just learn to keep your mouth shut.
In addition to those scientists who were willing to appear on camera, we encountered many more who didn't dare show their face for fear of losing their jobs.
You use an intelligent design perspective to get the research done, but you're not allowed to talk about it in public.
And so there is definitely incentive, if you think about it, for people to remain within the mainstream.
You know, what's he up to? What is he thinking? Is he one of them? That kind of thing.
If I write intelligent design, they hear creationism. They hear religious right. They hear theocracy.
So it appears Mr. Shermer, the self-styled skeptic, was wrong on this one. Intelligent design was being suppressed in a systematic and ruthless fashion. But maybe intelligent design should be suppressed. I didn't like what was happening to these scientists, but on the other hand, we don't want our kids being taught that the Earth is flat or that the Holocaust never happened. It was time to ask the scientific establishment what was so bad about intelligent design.
Intelligent design people are not genuine scientists.
Intelligent design is a racket.
It's just propaganda.
The only intelligent thing about it is to have got people to call it that.
It's really very stupid as well. Huh? Everybody knows science education in America is appalling. What we don't need at this time is intelligent design in the classrooms.
To present intelligent design stunts their educational growth. It stunts their intellectual growth.
But what I don't understand is how these animals could have been on Earth millions of years before man. And the Bible says the whole Earth was created in only 6 days.
It wasn't just the educational aspects of intelligent design that had scientists concerned. Many suspected the movement masked a much larger agenda.
Intelligent design is a set of excuses to squeeze creationism into the classrooms.
Get intelligent design in the schools today, and we can have school prayers tomorrow.
Any other complaints?
Can you imagine anything more boring? The boredom attached to ID is supreme. It is so boring that I can't even bother to think about it much anymore. It's just utterly boring.
Love is in the air, everywhere I look around. Love is in the air, every sight and every sound.
Love was in the air, all right, but none of it was directed toward intelligent design. There seemed to be a lot to hate about ID, and nearly all of that hatred was focused on one place.
The people from the Discovery Institute, the people who are doing the intelligent design, they're all varnish and no product.
The Discovery Institute is a propaganda mill. It's an institution designed to suck in money from religious investors and turn it into a sanitized, somewhat secular version of the creation story to get it into the schools.
If they have a way of understanding nature that's superior to the one that we all are making lots of discoveries using, great. Bring it on.
We are really, really lost. I think it's on third. I think it's on third. I think it's down there. I have no idea where this place is. I guess I just keep walking. Do you have any idea where the Discovery Institute is? Have you ever heard of that?
Never heard of it.
Okay, thank you. How are you, sir? Good. Do you have any idea where the Discovery Institute is?
Not a clue.
Discovery Institute.
Thank you. It's very kind of you to offer.
Welcome to Seattle.
Thank you, sir. It's got to be this whole building. Yes, where is the Discovery Institute, please?
Discovery Institute on the main floor, suite 808.
Okay. Very good. Aha! Success at last. Aha! We found you. Are you Bruce Chapman?
I am.
How are you? I'm Ben Stein. Well, very kind of you to have me here.
I'm delighted to meet you.
Can I look around and see your options?
Absolutely.
Do you just have this floor, or do you have several other floors as well?
No,